बट
ऑडिबल सर।
यू आर वेरी मच ऑडिबल। डियर फ्रेंड्स, मिस्टर शिव सतीश, मैनेजर ऑफ आवर चेन्नई आरएसटीसी लर्निंग सेंटर, न्यू नेम फॉर आरएसटीसी इज लर्निंग सेंटर। आवर शिव सतीश इज सीनियर मैनेजर हियर। ही विल बी टेकिंग दिस सेशन ऑन रिटेल लेंडिंग। ही विल बी शोइंग थ्रू हिज पावर पॉइंट। इफ यू वॉन्ट दिस पावर पॉइंट वी विल शेयर लेटर। ओवर टू मिस्टर शिव सतीश।
Is Philippines coming, sir?
या
Okay, friends. Good afternoon. Hearty welcome. Hearty congratulations for taking up the promotion process. Actually, the faculty are lined up, Mr. Jagannath sir and Ravi Kumar sir. Actually, I was a stop of arrangement because Ravi sir is having exam today. I wish to because it's a the topic is retail. I will try to cover retail and other basics also in 2 hours allotted for me. So it's warm up because actually Mr. Ravi sir and Jagannath will be covering all topics tomorrow, sugar sir. So it's getting best, making best use of their contents because they have prepared and structured it very well. So I'll just introduce you to all the basic concepts, including retail and retail more, and then forex. Then you can make best use of other faculty's lessons. Okay. Now as I told you, you should know your bank. What is because. Whether bank when why the bank wants to promote you because bank wants more people at counters officer level because whatever being a business institution bank always looks up profits only. So even promotion process also everything the whatever bank does it does for its we have to the ultimate goal is to get more profits only. So our role is we have to because know your bank know your role we have to exit our role that means na. Even for promotion process also, it is not need as a exam. I am repeatedly telling you, don't grab too much material. Also, I think a small correction, Ravi sir, because they may be having 200 questions. I think workman to officer, 20 English also there. I think so around 180 questions from topics will be there. I think I'm not sure. I'll just confirm. It is workman to officer 200 questions, 20 English will be there. So all topics they may be getting multiple questions. So. As we analyze the pattern, the coming 1 to 2 to 3, the more not direct questions, it is somewhat tough only, and it is concept based. More questions came from concept rather than routine topics. Na, so be thorough and whatever topic you are taking, go through the concepts first. Is now because they have covered much more concepts in all levels, either 1 to 2 to 3. All these we have analyzed the pattern. So now that's why because now bank is also scientifically moving. Whatever test they are giving. They are not only simply circular based or concept based or system based. They are testing your core expertise. They are testing your functional importance to the bank. So you must be prepared for it. It is not that much tough, not that much easy, but it is a comprehensive test. All tests we have seen this year, the tests are comprehensive in all aspects. They are touching each and every aspect. So you be thorough with all aspects, and you can guess your paper also. Once you excel your role, no, that is our logic. Then. A simple logic. How many of you bought Canara Bank shares with your arrears, sir? Do you think our bank is performing well? Of course, you should because we are working the bank. We can't say no. Because how many of you bought? Because lot of arrears were paid at least 1 lakh, 2 lakhs. At least anyone bought 10 shares. Anyone, sir? At least will give a cup to you. Anyone at least bought 10 shares of Canara Bank with your arrears? Because we are asking this question all because it's very important. Unless that means you have not bought at least 10 shares of your Canara Bank shares when bank has paid 1 lakh, 2 lakhs arrears. Our share is around 130, 120 now. That means if you can't spare 1200 rupees as an investment in your bank, then where is the conviction that you will be excelling? Because there lies the conviction too. Because we are expecting this type of interview also. Na? Because we have to demonstrate conviction when you are going to. Down higher roles, bank should feel that this guy is capable of doing more tasks and attending more tasks, all these things. So all please at least make a habit because when you are in the bank, if you are not owning your bank, we can't do because promotion process is a part of our job. Because bank can it's because if you are don't take too much stress. Over 2 weeks time is there, you can't make up enter material. Na? You casually focus your strengths. At least you will be handling some desk. That topics you cover, whatever you know, you remind and just answer those questions comfortably. And all topics, the bank is very simple. One is KYC. There are some structural verticals are there. All verticals, basics, you know. At least because as the analysis, any exam paper, 30 to 40 questions, easy questions are coming. 30% 40% very fundamental questions are coming. If you are thorough in these fundamentals, that 40% cakewalk for you. Remaining 60-50 term were tough, but that only you have to prepare. So please start preparation of now itself. And already last year, in 2 months back, uploaded one material there in our logic, or in STC vertical. 3-4 days down the line, we are uploading one more material in Candle. That book is enough. It is up to date up to 15 Jan. Beyond that, nothing will come. So that book, you go through it. There we have structurally covered all the topics, and that is enough. Don't spend too much time on accumulating materials, all these things. So this is very important when you go for interview also, because all got lakh, 1 lakh, 2 lakhs. This is really, we have to ask this question in the interview. How many shares you bought? This is very, very important attribute. If you are not even buying 10 shares, means I can't trust that you are having conviction to lead the bank. Very important. If anyone says yes in this group, I am the happiest person. At least 10 shares, at least one share, 130 rupees. If you can invest in bank, means you are wonderful. You will excel. You will take the bank to higher heights. Very important. Now coming to the exam, because that I told you, because aspirants have to, that player and conviction to be there. This is only test in exams. The question framing, everything will be from this angle only. Take it for granted. We have seen 1, 2, 3, all papers, somewhat tough, and they tested our material. Not that much easy. So prepare well. This material, you go through it, and surplus also very important, they will cover. You go through them. Now, because on 3-4 basic points, we're going to retail cover you, because all are interlinked, risk weight, you should know. What are the advantages of retail, all these things? So, what is the capital required for starting a bank? Can I start a bank now? Is it possible to start a bank, sir? And tomorrow, I want to start a bank. What is the capital required? This is very important. It is on-tap licensing. Anyone can start a bank any moment. India, because earlier gone, now banking licenses are given on-tap. If you are having 500 crores capital, you can start a bank. That is the competition of our field. Anyone can enter the field. This is very important. Second one, this is the basic, because when you are in the bank, you must understand the basic equation. Why I want to give you stress retail loans? Because the basic banking, you have to simplify. Don't complicate your knowledge. Because banking is one of the simplest tasks in the world. Make it simple once again. What bank is doing, we are taking deposits. With this deposits, can I lend everything? No. What I have to do? Then, because if you understand this question, we can understand the importance of retail. D is called deposit. If I am taking 100 rupees deposit, can I invest everything in assets? All car loans I can give? No. So what is the equation? The basic banking equation is deposit is equal to C plus S plus A. What is C? Sir, Ravi sir, what is C is our cash reserve ratio, because RBI is saying, government is saying, whatever amount you are taking as deposits, don't dump in the market as advances. You must have some C. Then what it is saying, C is now how much? Then what is S? I'll just cover you. What is S? It is standard liquidity ratio. So whatever deposits you are taking, a bank is supposed to keep C plus S. Another one, lending. So these are the three components. One end, we are taking deposit. On the other end, we are having three sources. How to deploy the deposits? This is very important. Any bank must have at least 500 crores capital to start a bank. 500 crores minimum capital required to start a bank in India. Then the first and foremost equation is D is equal to C plus S plus A. That means 100 rupees deposit you are paying interest. You will not get interest on C. That means 4 rupees, now it is 4, no, it is gone. This is the, what is CRR now? Anyone says, that will cover, Nestle will cover you. And SLR, it is 90, because C plus S have gone. S will give you very rate of interest. So that portion you remove on balance advances, you must earn interest. So where you deploy, basing on your deployment of the assets, either retail, agri, MSME, corporate, 4 segments are there from operational point of view in banking. RAMSI will call retail, agri, MSME, corporate. So this assets distribution will help you in getting more profits, more sustainability. So in some cases, if assets are not paid, the stressed assets means you have to keep provision for it. And the simple third solution is stressed assets minus provision is equal to 0 in 5 years. This is what a bank is expected to do. RBI is simple. If you are, all bankers must understand this equation. if you understand this equation, whatever you do, you can do perfectly. So you can contribute to the bank. So it is very simple. You are taking public money, you are lending. Out of entire amount, you can't lend. Some C+S is safer. Suppose out of 100 loans you have given, 10 have gone bad. RBI is not bothered. At least all 100 gone bad. We are not bothered. What they are saying, you have to tell you the equation. If an asset is going bad, within 5 years, you keep full provision for it. That's all. The standard, substandard, doubtful movement. This is the basic equation of banking. You try to understand this. Once you understand this entire, you can structure your knowledge on it. What is the provision? What is fine? So, D is equal to C+S+A. Sometimes, so all assets may not be strand assets. They may be stressed assets. Or for them, you have to keep provision. And the logic is, out of assets, any stressed assets are there, SA minus P is equal to 0. That means, for all stressed assets, you must have 100% provision. That's all. This is called, AD is called CD ratio of the bank. So, very important. What is the CD ratio of the bank now? So CD ratio of the bank. Yes, sir. Then the second important aspect, how much deposits a bank can accept? Whether our bank can accept 20 crore or 20 lakh crore deposits, is it possible, sir? How much deposits we can accept? Very important. Second, this is a very important aspect. Being we are having 10,000 plus branches, can each branch accept 100 crore deposit? No. Because deposit taking ability of the bank also linked to capital. That is called leverage ratio. Very important. Bank is pegged to capital in both ends. The same way, advances also, we can't lend unlimited. Now, our capacity to lend, our capacity to onboard deposits, both are restricted to capital. This deposit, it is called leverage ratio. Advances, it is called capital adequacy CAR. Deposit, being a big bank, we can't have more than 4.5 to 5 leverage ratio, 3 to 5. That means you can't take more than 20 to 25% of times your capital. So that is very important. What is your capital now? This is a very important question. If December sheet comes, you just remember it. As on March, bank's own capital is 60,331 crores. This is because this is very important combined figure. Bank is having this much own money. So what is my capital? What is my net worth? Bank's own money is 66,000 crores. So how much deposit can take into 22 times, 25 times, basing on the so dynamic concept, basing on the RBI leverage ratio. Na? So into 22 times means into 20, how many times? 10, 6. Na? Still bank has capability to take more and amount, 25 times, 14,000 crores, it can take deposit. Capacity is there. Same way lending up to 9, capital adequacy, we can lend more because this is, as of now, we are having adequate capital for both deposit taking and lending operations. Then, what are the bank's vitals? The CD ratio, what is meant by CD ratio now? As of now, CRR is 3 and SLR is 18. We can lend up to 79. How much we lent? we'll end only 69. This is very, very important bank is facing. Now, why we want to stress this one? CD ratio of the bank is 69 as of September. How much you can lend? 100 rupees, 3 rupees CRR required. 18 rupees SLR, that means 21 rupees you keep aside. 79 rupees you can lend. Ideal CD is 79. What is our bank ratio? Less than 69. Around 69. That means 10 rupees for every 100 rupees you are not lend. You are not knowing how to lend. Simply dumping with government mass securities. They are paying very less amount and we are paying deposit higher interest. We are getting less amount. So this is the logic. Why? Because why retail is being pushed? Why all you want? Not the very important. So and other very important aspects, every quarter, our net interest, what is NII there? Because profitability aspects are very important. All office and promote is, these, what is net interest income, non-interest income, because NIM, CTI, these five we're expecting definitely have two questions. So these aspects also, because you be thorough. What is net interest income? It is interest received minus interest paid. How much our bank is getting per quarter, roughly, na? We are getting 6,000 crores of the interest income, net interest income. What is non-interest income? Around 3,000 crores we are getting. What is our cost? You see, 4,800 crores. Out of it, staff is 3,200. So there lies the catch. Every quarter, every month, we need 1,000 crores income to pay our staff salary. This is before arrears. Now at least 10%, that means 11 to 1,200 crores we need income per paying our salaries. Forget, because out of operating expenses, staff itself, na, this you should know your bank, because you are going to become officers. Now, this is the logic. Now, how to prepare for the bank? You must be, because each every na, because you are the frontline staff, operating staff. Now, you must be in a position to get more business, because you have to say at the end of the day, whatever you do, retail, you give all these, give, we want profit only. So you should know your bank position. Na? Net interest income every quarter, how much bank is getting? 6,000 crores interest income we are getting. Non-interest income, 3,000 crores. That means around 9,500 crores you are getting. But where the money is going? 4,000, around 5,000 crores gone. Out of it, 3,000 crores to employees only. So this is very important, friends. How to get more income profits means I can't reduce your salary. I can't reduce my premises rent, all these things. Only thing is I have to increase my net interest income. How to do it? Either give more loans or give more high-cost loans, except in retail lending loans, except housing loan, all are giving me good return. So that's the importance of retail lending loans, because that's why bank is pushing loans. Earlier, 4 months salary we used to give. Now, how much you are giving? Base is 6 months for housing loans. Then 7 months you can give, 8 months COA head can give. Because why? I want to push more lending in stable and revenues to good sources of income. Car loan I am giving. For staff, we are not giving accessories. For customer, we are giving accessories up to 25,000 rupees. Why? That is the logic of reason. Because we need more income. Why retail means? Because why the bank is retail means? These figures, all bankers must know. But when you are going for promotion, our CD ratio is 69. Or less than 69. As on September. Ideal ratio is 79. You can go up to 79. Because CRR is 3, SLR 18. 21 is there. 100 rupees deposit, so and you can lend 79 rupees. You are lending 69. This is very important. Then non-interest income, these four in the, you have to vitals of the bank. Net interest income, what is that? This is because what all 1,000 branches, 90,000 employees were dying day in, day out. At the end of the day, market sees only these four things. So these are the input. From these aspects only, examiner will send the questions, because we want more people. Who can excel me? Who can give me more income? I mean, in exam process, I don't want to test your ability to remember all these things. I want people who are practical, who can give me more income. Am I right? I'm a businessman. I'm not a college professor or a college. This is not a school. And so banking test is not an academic test. Very important. That way you prepare. It is not, this test is not going to test your academic material. We are going to test you in your functional expertise. We are going to test your core expertise in functional areas. Being a scale one officer, you will be manning the counters or all operating desks. So how strong an operational knowledge, na? That angle only all questions will come. I will confirm you tomorrow, because the question paper, 200 questions will be there, 20 English. Na? So lot of questions will be there. Try to answer more number of questions, na? Very important. So you must be thorough in all fundamentals. So this is very, income experts should be thorough. Why retail push we are giving all these things? Na? Our interest income is very less. 10,000 branches you divide na, 6,000 crores only we are getting interest income. Net interest income. What is your non-interest income? You just because these figures, why I am stressing na, because retail na, unless you have, it goes into your mind. Because nothing big, you should know because we are a team. 90,000 employees team. And our bank needs every month at least 1,000 crores. Now we have to say arrears, 1,200 crores income to pay our salaries. And to pay our establishment, they need one more, another 1,000, 5,000 crores. We need income to sustain ourselves. Then only profit will come. That is the logic. So we have to pull up our socks. In this way, you prepare. That's why retail is being pushed, MSME is being pushed, to ensure more and income. From an exam point of view also, one question will definitely come. CD ratio, net interest income, non-interest income, operating expenses, what is staff cost? You must be just visualize. Every quarter, this is the figure. Around 9,000 crores you are earning, 5,000 you are spending. 4,000 operating profit is coming, out of it provisions are eating. So this is net interest margin. Cost to income ratio means our cost, that means operating expenses should be less than 50% of our total income. Here, ours is 54. This also na operating income. CTA is very important. The cost to income ratio. It is a cost means operating expenses divided by net interest income plus non-interest income. Here at 9,000 you got. You should be less than this one. We are more than 4,500 crores. That means 50% reached. The global benchmark is 50%. So all these things you factor while you're preparing. So questions will come in these lines only. How the bank can excel? I like that you prepare. Okay. Then. So CRR and CRR is 3. SLR, one question will definitely come. You have to buy hard. There will not be any change. Because already revised. CRR is 3 means 100 rupees deposit. You have to keep 3 rupees deposit with in cash form with the RBI. SLR, what do you mean by SLR? SLR means it is security ratio. Na, for every 100 rupees deposit, you have to keep 18 rupees with Reserve Bank of India, say accrued securities. That means government securities. That means what is the purpose of last night? We got one question. What is the purpose of CRR and SLR? The purpose is to safeguard the interest of the depositors. That means 100 rupees deposit you are keeping. 21 is safe. Remaining 7 bank is lending in the market. So that is important. Then other important question. Repo is a common question because all retail lending loans are priced in repo. RLLR means repo linked lending rate. So this is very important. What is meant by repo? Repo is repurchase agreement. It is the rate at which we can borrow from RBI. Reverse repo is rate at which RBI will give you when you are parking your securities. So why we are concerned? 100 rupees deposit bank is RBI is saying you lend 679 rupees. We are lending 69 rupees and parking 10 with RBI. How much they are giving? 3.35. How much you are paying depositors? Average 4.55. We are on the one end, even after COVID, deposit inflow has not stopped. Lending is not picking up. So what we are doing, we are simply parking with funds with Government of India, RBI. They are paying because why they normally repo and reverse repo difference will be only 0.25. Now what RBI did, they purposefully reduce the rate of interest of reverse repo. This is very important question. So 3.35, you remember, reverse repo is definitely coming. Reverse repo, MSF, bank rate. Repo, you remember, 4. MSF and bank will be 0.25. Reverse will be 0.25 less normally. But RBI made it a point because not only 0.25, 0.65 reduced. Why? Because they want the banks to push to lend. Reverse repo, very important. This is quarter rate, you buy heart. Why RBI reduced the reverse repo rate? They asked in 4 to 5. Why? Because to push the banks to lend. This is also very important question. And one more definite question. Who will give benchmark rates in India for lending all these things? It is Financial Benchmarks India Limited. Definite question for the scale 0 to 1 because the operator to 1, you buy heart. That's definite question. Financial benchmarks, all benchmarks. India is also going to global standards. RBI is not giving benchmark rates. It is FBIL, Financial Benchmarks India Limited. This. Then provisions and risk weight also definitely questions will come. Because we have to go because provisions eat away our profits. Risk weight, they will restrict our lending expertise because we have to have that capital adequacy. They'll be covering it. Okay. Then what is meant by RAMSI? Now coming to the core topic. What is meant by RAMSI? RAMSI, because we have lending verticals, 4 lending verticals are there. broadly it is called retail, agri, MSME, corporate. Because retail means, what is meant by retail lending loans? Given goes to individual platform and that loans were not corporate. Now we can have, because normally we are classifying as per Basel different definition. Normal as lending practice, retail loans means loan given to individual sectors. They help in retail loans, help in wealth building of the customers. Because if you are giving a housing loan, what is the purpose of it? You just analyze. Normally retail lending loans, the basic premise is they'll build the wealth. You are giving me a housing loan, you are adding to my wealth. You are giving me car loan, you are giving status, you are giving me educational loan, you are building my capacity or retail. So any branch, you think like that, if the retail lending purpose, they help in wealth building. What is the percentage? Our bank, out of 100 rupees loans we are giving, we are dumping 44.26 in corporate, MSME 16.91, agri 24.7, retail 16.97. Out of all the four verticals, which is highly being paid, which advance is highly lucrative? Corporate, they will not dance to our tunes. So big advance, they will squeeze us. Whatever they dictate, we have to go, because lending is not in our hand. Data of industry is not in our hand, pricing. Then in agri also, highly regulated, we can't price more. Out of all these four segments, RAMC, retail and MSME are the core segments where we get more yield. I told you, because net interest income, because to get more profits, I have to increase my net income only. I can't cut my expenditure. I told you expenditure, out of my expenditure, 1,200 crores going to operating expenses, 3,200 crores to staff employees. Employee salary, I can't cut down. Operating also, only even if I put up the lights, all these things, I can't reduce drastically. So we can't contain expenditure. What we can do? We can augment income. Income generating is at all levels, bank, whatever you are doing, whether you are training, going for promotion days, everything, you must gain the, you are preparing now for the exams. This preparation also, you think in that way that this knowledge should help you in lending more. Not only lending, earning more. I don't say it is not learning more. Whatever you learn, you should help a bank in earning more. Either by way of deposit earning or by way of lending, everything, non-interest income, all these things. So definitely some questions will be coming, because non-interest income, you must know what are the processing charges bank is taking for all the loans. Because I can't read all the loans. In our logic book, we have given on table. You just remember the processing charges. You can't, if you remember now also, you forget. Before going to exam, have a glance of processing charges of all our loans. Housing, agriculture, vehicle, all these things. The sheet is given, logic book in circular. We are uploading in CANET tomorrow. That book you go through before going to exam. Not now, because you will forget. 13th is the exam date. Around 10th, 11th, you go through all the processing charges, documentation charges we are taking, mortgage charges. Retail lending, mortgage we are not taking. These, because bank is also charging, because your charges, I told you, non-interest income very important. Because interest income we are getting only 6,000 crores. That is why you can't lend, because you can't rise it. Because why? The lending is linked to RLLR. MCLR is slowly being replaced by RLLR. When RLLR loans are coming, you have to link the pricing to the repo rate only. When repo is 4, I can't charge 9. So the only way is non-interest income now. At the end of the day, bank's figure is this only bank, because we have to, if you crystallize the entire business into three lines, these three lines only will stand. What is your net interest income, non-interest income, operating expenses? Basing on that only, everything is there. Your MD salary, your investment, shareholders, stakeholders, everything. These three lines only matter, whatever you do. So I can't continue. I repeatedly telling, I can't reduce my staff cost, this one. What I should do? I can't interest my net interest income also, because CASA, overnight I can't bring it CASA now more, because net interest income to be more means you have to improvise your CASA figures. Now even CASA rate of interest and deposit also not that much variance. Earlier I used to pay CASA 9.7. So CASA is 3.4. Now you see the CASA rate of interest and the deposit is almost similar only, 3.5, 4.5. So that advantage also gone. So and at the same time I can't increase my lending rate, because it's repo linked. If I charge more, customers will vanish. So very important is non-interest income. There lies the, we analyze the pattern. Even questions from 2 to 3 also, they touch in non-interest income aspects only. BC aspects, how to issue LC, all these aspects about documentation charges. Any how that, because you should know how to get more income. They asked Aadhaar service kendra income, they asked, they are, because all social security schemes marketing, they asked, because same definite question now, if you sell a gold bond, what is the commission of the bank? Very important. How many of you have bought gold at least? Forget Canara Bank shares. How many of you bought gold bonds from your areas? Nobody, because employees, because if you buy something through online, we are getting 50 rupees commission. Each bank, or small banks are pushing it. People are buying gold bonds. Well, we have to open up because their license, because question will definitely come. What is the commission if you sell for gold bond is 50 rupees. And what is the price if you, the party books through online, definite question, 50 rupees less per gram you will be getting. So what is the interest being paid on gold bond? 2.5% per annum. Because questions came, because wherever income source is there, questions are coming from that aspect. Adult pension yojana, this one, also, you know, because saving schemes, government scheme, government not, no, it is not government sponsored schemes, government business, because we have analyzed the trend, government business schemes, questions are coming from government business portals. What are government business avenues? Capital gains accounts, capital gain bonds, sovereign gold bonds, all these things, we are getting a lot of questions. So capital gain, this sovereign gold bond scheme, entire one pager is there. You go through it thoroughly. What the rate of interest, when you can exit, how to opt, 5 years is the lock-in, 8 years exit option. Simple, it is because mark linked to 3 days average price. You be 2.5% interest they are paying. You can take loan on it. So all these gold bonds and bank advantage, they are buying gold 50 rupees commission I'm getting without any work. Same way Aadhaar service kendra, they are asking questions. I mean, what the fees for Aadhaar updation, mobile number 50 rupees. Any change of address? Because like that, you focus, the questions will come from more and more touching the non-interest income aspect. Very important. And security aspect, because now recovery, all these things, so then. Then MSME also highly, 16.97 is the retail figure. One more question definitely comes. What is out of 16.97, what is the housing loan portfolio of Canara Bank as of September? Is it 1 lakh crore? Is it 5? But roughly we just analyzed, it is around 50,000 crores. Very important. Housing loan portfolio is not that big in Canara Bank. It is in 55,000 crores only. Very important. 57 something is there. This you remember in March figure, September, December figures come, you just remember it. Housing loan total aggro, because gross they are asking in 4 to 5. They are framing a gross level of housing loan for amount, housing loan portfolio size, vehicle loan, because out of vehicle loans, we call triumvirate. Three loans are more popular. What are three popular loans in vehicle loans? Housing, vehicle, and EL. Very, very important questions are coming from it. You, these three schemes only you have to thorough, because these three schemes only are drivers of retail lending. Out of, because 16, 100 rupees retail I am giving, 90% are coming from these three loans only. 50% around 55 from housing, 20 from retail, this vehicle loans, 10 to 15 from education loans. Remaining all loans combined, it is getting 15% only segment-wise. You can see the segment-wise analysis in our September figures. So these three schemes, we are creating large number of questions. Main thing, main questions, trump questions, eligibility norms. Say 6 months, 6 years, 7 years, 8 years. Exit and entry age also very important. Margin also definitely they are asking, because how much we are financing? 30 lakhs, only 10% margin we are considering. Even the GST also we are considering. This one, 30 to 75 lakhs, 20% margin we are taking. Housing loans, you be thorough. 75 lakhs, 25% margin. Second hand house, 20% margin. Our margin is competitive. And some amount reimbursement also are doing it. 25% reimbursement. Then the entry age, very, very important. Up to 60 and within 75, it is given to RSA. 70 to 75 also, RH and above. Above 70 also, selectively we are giving. These are very little. 70 years above also, we are giving loan. This is also very important. And one more feature, repayment tenure for individual house, 24 months we are giving. Apartment, 36 months we are giving. If it is more than, if the party wants more, 36 and 48 possible. So this is what, there are three trump cards, because how to sell our housing loan. We are giving for more than 70 also. Then very important, what is your strength is repayment capacity, repayment holidays. individual flat 24 months I can give. Individual plot construction. Apartments 36 months I can give. If party wants much more, individual flats, individual 36 months I am giving. Apartments I can give 48 months. Almost, this is best in the market. So the definitely question will come. So like that, wherever how the questions are framing, you analyze because exceptions. If they, because one is IT returns are not there, whose power like that. So how retail lending loans, we are expecting around because 200 marks, 100 marks paper means 10 questions will come. 200 means 220 will come. Because don't spend too much time on any topic. As the pattern says, the mix, they are having a perfect mix of all topics. And conventional topics, they are omitting. And retail lending loans in 1 to 2, hardly 8 questions came. As per the analysis, as per recalled questions, only 7 to 8 questions came. So you focus on main schemes. Canara rent, they are asking. Canara mortgage, also, they are not asking. Very simple one, they asked. So because housing, car loan, educational loan, you go. And the common question, whether CGFSL is there for abroad studies or not, common question. Yes or no, definite, all market, no. Up to 5 lakhs, 7.5 lakhs, even for abroad studies also guarantee is there. Definite question for this exam, you just remember it. CGFSL coverage is there, even for 7.5 lakhs, even for abroad studies also very important. Common question, because all think that is only for domestic. No, both domestic and abroad, up to 7.5 lakhs, you can give education loans liberally. Why? Because the party is not paying, you just simply file student recover money from the guarantee cover. So this is because bank wants this to push. Vijayaturan, this I understand is somewhat tougher. Only high levels, to very few students will be getting it. 7.5 lakhs, you can dump anywhere. And cover is there. That's all simple. And even abroad studies also you can cover. So up to 7.5 lakhs, you can give this without abroad studies also with guarantees, without any collateral. Vehicle loan also, margin 10, 15, like the very simple margin. Actually is up to 20% we are covering. So all these trump you remember, very important. 72 months salary we are giving RSA. 84 months, very important. 25% net take home with 20% discount, remember. The 8 months salary, 8 years salary we are giving with this one. CO head for urban and metros only. Like the Canara housing loan corporate is there. All these, lot of schemes are there under retail lending. So all schemes you go through it. And because today, I was given a miscript, I have to cover basics of all topics, retail with focus and some forex. All three I will cover. So, friends, so I covered basics, the CRR, these SLR ratios, CRR, different questions are there. Reverse repo, one question will come. And financial benchmarks of India Limited, one question. This housing loan acceptance, we are covering that risk weight, I will cover later. This entry age, exit age, very important. As of now, bank has no exit age because we can say that exit age is not really demarked. Sanctioning they have given, but entry above 70 also we have power. That means exit is not defined. And repayment term, very important that you buy out something 24, 36 for normal individual houses, 36, 48 for this one, apartments, tripartite agreements. They can stretch. Unique selling point for Canara Bank. So these are the various important schemes. So focus on these and don't be confined to only one topic. You have to go through all topics and only basics they are touching. So now we'll cover. So very important retail lending also. Retail lending also recovery aspect they have touched. If any loan goes bad, the Canara budget, Canara vehicle, educational loans. You are don't bother about the recovery. Simply what you have to do is, what is meant by OA, OS, common questions are coming in a retail lending loans. OA means original application in DRT. OS means original suit in civil court. Don't bother about NPAs in retail lending. We can recover easily. So if you file suit, exam point of view, when you file OA in DRT, the loan amount is about 20 lakhs. So they will give. The DRT is tri-structure, presiding officer will be there, recovery officer will be there, registrar will be there. He will give OA number to you, judge, presiding officer will give judgment. He is DRT judgment is called common question. They asked recovery certificate in DRT. You will get in normal court. You get a decree. In DRT, you get a recovery certificate. In Lok Adalat, you get award. Educational loans recovery is a dicey area in Canara Bank. We are because that's why last in the last month exams now we got two to three questions from recovery aspects. So what is the best source of recovery? Educational loans, either OTS party is not coming. You just remember that 100% you have to file suit in educational loan. 0% mercy for educational loans defaulters. Wherever defaults are there, because in genuine cases you recover, you bring them to OTS. OTS possible ELR simplified is there. 90, try to get OTS. If OTS is not clicking, party is really not in a dire straits. Bank is recommending recovery process. Recovery should not, from an exam point of view, just remember there are two modes of recovery. One is you have to immediately file suit. So file suing means there are two numbers. DRT will give OA number. What is meant by OA number means original application number. If you file a suit in DRT, if you file a suit in court, they will give original suit number. OS or OA. Original application, original suit. When the proceedings happen, DRT will issue RC, very important, recovery certificate. Court will issue decree. That by execution of decree, you have to go to revenue officers. In DRT, one recovery officer is there. That's all. So then judgment came, borrower became judgment debtor. Last time came, what is JDR means? Judgment debtor. Once we got a judgment in our favor, the borrower becomes judgment debtor. Bank will become judgment creditor. Even local awards are given by local adalat courts. Local adalat courts are awards also valid for 12 years. Limitation for local adalat award, any judgment given by local adalat settlement award, very important question, 12 years. So if your party is not paying also, to avoid litigation, all these things, try to bring him to local adalat, just settle the some settlement there. It's a fair judgment. Once that award is given, the limitation is 12 years. Very, very important. Local adalat award, decree or recovery certificate. 12 years is the limitation period. Within that 12 years period, we can recover the amount. Very important. That is called JDR, JDC, JCR. Then IBC is Insolvency Bankruptcy Code. There the judgment trials will be held in NCLT and NCLAT. That is important. That's enough. This level of enough. Workman officer. You just remember IBC is... It's a beyond, because it is not a substitute for SERFACI. Very important. These are the recovery actions. Filing, suit, SERFACI, IBC, all these things. This is insolvency proceedings. You have to apply in NCLAT and NCLAT are the adjudicating authorities. This you remember that, sir. SERFACI, sir, will be covering. SERFACI, you have to in all secured assets. Very important. So this you remember. And delegation of powers, all Ravi Kumar sir is covering regarding detail. My other schemes, the Canara Mortgage and Canara Rent. So I focused more on education, housing and EL and Canara Vehicle. These three only I covered. Very important. These three also, they're asking very simple questions only, not that much tough. Margin, they're asking all processing charges you go through before exam once. That's all. Questions came from processing only last time, all levels. They asked only processing charges. Even 3 to 4 also they asked only processing charges. Because I told you the logic behind is bank is testing the income generating expertise of the participant. Promoters also, promotion aspirants also, we are testing the income generation aspects. So that's why all questions are being framed like that only. All last three exams are really unconventional only. I'm repeat telling you, you have to fine tune your preparation skills. Okay. Now I'll go through, because only half an hour left, I will go through Forex now. So for like the retail, foreign exchange is also a very simple topic, at least because 10 questions you will get. These simple questions you don't mix. Wherever the questions are simple and fundamental, thus topics you first mug up. KYC, this retail lending, basic schemes, foreign exchange, basic NRI deposits, all these things. Locker, SDL, limitation, bankers, trade relationship, trustee, bailer, bailer, all these things. Any exam, 30% these simple questions will come. That somehow you have to crack. You should not mix. You should not fumble. Once that 30% you are issued, the remaining you can focus. The that you can take with you, you spend more time, but don't miss the fundamental aspects. Don't net interesting, how to open a basic deposit, how many currencies bank is having, all these things, some fundamental questions will be there. I'll be covering it. So fixed rate will be there. Because the abbreviations, remember, Reserve Bank of India, FEDAI means Foreign Exchange Dealers Association of India. DGFT means Director General of Foreign Trade. Indian Customs, CIBIL and ICC will be there in foreign exchange. Exact concept only I will tell you. Very important. Foreign exchange rates are important. There are two types of course. Very, very important. We are following, nowadays we are fully converted. We are following two course. Suppose foreign exchange, we are dealing with foreign currency. Anything other than Indian currency is called foreign exchange. So, foreign exchange, there are two types of quotes, direct and indirect quote. Direct quote means, simple example, I want to buy some apples. Direct quote means, I ask the rate of apple. What is the rate of one apple? So, if he is by selling to for 4 rupees, make profit, I have to sell for 5 rupees. So, in direct quote, buy low, sell high. This is common question. There are two types of quotes in foreign exchange. Definite question in the levels. So by direct quote, what is meant by quote? How to quote a rate? So in foreign exchange, there are two mechanisms. One is direct indirect quotes. Direct quote means I am asking what is the price of an apple? He is selling 10 rupees means I buy it. If I want to sell it to make money, I should sell it 11 rupees. That is can't die. That is so the form maxim is so maxim is buy low, sell high. In indirect quote, we'll ask them in how many apples I will get for 100 rupees. That means suppose he is getting 5 apples or 100 rupees. To get profit, I should sell only 4. There, buy high, sell low. Just to remember this example, what is the rate of an apple? How many apples I will get for 100 rupees? These are the two quotes prevalent foreign exchange. The maxims are buy low, sell high. And we are now, India is following direct and dual quote system. Both buying and selling will be there. That is, all left hand will be buying rate, right will be selling rate. And there are 4 tenor rates, very, very important. Ready purchase means immediate. Ready purchase, immediate take ready purchase. Tomorrow is T+1, next working day, very important. Yesterday's tomorrow is Monday only, next working day. Spot means T+2 working days. Forward means any other settlement. Very important that this is one question is assured. That direct and direct quote, one question assured of 4 tenor rates are there. Ready purchase, sale means immediate transaction will be happening. That is ready TTC buying TTC rate. TOM means T+1. That means today is transaction happening. The settlement will happen on next working day. So what is the working TOM of Friday? It is Saturday and Sunday holidays globally. So Monday. What is the term for this one? Monday, it will be Tuesday. Next, whenever it is working day, next working day is the term date. Spot means the next second working day. Suppose Friday is, term is Monday, spot is Tuesday. We have to remove 2 holidays. In between holidays, we have to remove next working day, next second working day. There are 4 rates in foreign exchange. One definite question will be there. One is ready purchase, tomorrow, spot, forward. Ready purchase, TOM, spot, forward. Then same. Then instrument-based classification. TT means telegraphic transfer means immediately funds came to you. Foreign currency means currency purchase. Traveler's check means it is displayed. Now they are using travel cards. It is just a theory only. And bill. Bill means any foreign exchange bill. Import bill or export bill. Then transaction-based means buying and selling. If you buy from the party, it is called buying rate. If you sell to the party, it is selling rate. When we buy, very important now, always definite, very important question. Exporters, always we buy and inward remittances. Importers and outward remittances, we sell. Very, very important. any export customer, they will be having foreign exchange with them. We buy from them. Import customers, they need foreign exchange, because suppose somebody is importing from France, he needs euros. We sell them. So exporters, we buy. And NRI customers are equal to exporters while opening NRI deposits. They are equal to importers while closing NRI deposits. Okay, this is very important. And definite question, last time also all question papers it came, Nostro, Vostro, Loro, common question in all levels. What is a Nostro account? Our account with them in foreign currency, that means Canara Bank, any our bank, my account is there in foreign currency, any location, the account should be in foreign currency. That is called Nostro account. Our account with them in foreign currency is called Nostro account. Vostro account is any foreign bank's account with us in Indian rupees. It is called Vostro account. Nostro, Vostro, definite question. Nostro will be always in foreign currency. Vostro will be in always Indian rupees. Then what is Loro? It is third party's Nostro. If Lakshmi Vilas Bank is using Canara Bank's Nostro account, our account will become Loro for it. So Loro and Nostro accounts always in foreign currency only. Definite question. Loro, Nostro, Vostro, one question, 100%. What is Nostro account? I'll just quickly get na account in foreign currency with somebody else. Vostro account is any foreign bank's account with us in India. Loro means our account, any for the third party's Nostro account, na some Lakshmi Vilas Bank, a City Union Bank, any other bank, small banks. If they are using our account, any foreign currency account, that is friend's account. Friend's Nostro account is called Loro account. My friend bank's Loro account, Nostro account becomes Loro. These two are always in foreign currency. Vostro is in Indian rupees. These are about basic questions. Na? And FEMA also common question. FEMA is Foreign Exchange Management Act. One question will come. Only question is Section 2VI. That only defines the residential status in India. Resident means he has to stay at least for 183 days in India. That is very important. 365 by 2, 182.5. Na? He should stay at least of 50% more. That comes to 183. You remember like that. Any person staying in India for more than 182, or he has to stay at least minimum 183 days in India. 183 plus, you remember. That's all. He is resident in India. But exclusion is, suppose the EL student is there. He stayed in India entire throughout year in March. This March, he went to London. If the party is moving to US forever, even though he stayed here, na, any education student, job fellow, they are not called. They are empowered to open non-NRI accounts because they ceased to become residents. Even though they stayed for very important question, last time they asked, a student went to US in the month of March, whether he can be classed as resident or non-resident. That means last financial year he is staying entire in India only. Even then, he has the intention to leave Indian shore permanently, time being. So the moment they land in foreign shore, they can open NRI account. This exception is very important. Any employee, he is staying in India for the last 300 days. But now even he went away, he has the intention to stay there permanently. He is called resident. Same way some couple went for babysitting. They stayed there for more than 9 months. India, they stayed only say, 3 months or 3 months. But they don't have the intention to stay there permanently. So for them, you can't open NRI account. You can open NRI account only for NRI accounts only for non-resident Indians or PIOs or NRO account for foreign nationals. So for that only is important. Na? So any couple went to last time one question came, a couple went to US for medical surgery. They stayed there for 9 months. Can I open NRI account for them? Their stay is last financial year, they stayed in abroad only. No, because there is no intention to stay there permanently. So you can't open them NRI account. Yeah, employee, no, one boy, somebody got job in US. He left for US in the month of Feb only. Last year he stayed in India only. But now his intention there to stay abroad is forever. Now he want to stay there only. So you can open NRI account for them. This is the difference. Now, whom you can open NRI account? NRI account for non-resident Indians and PIOs. Who is a PIO? Very important question. PIO means person of Indian origin. There are three types of PIOs. Na? One is having Indian passport. Simply remember like that. There are three classes of PIOs. Person having Indian passport at some time because na, he was sometime Indian citizen, now he became a foreign citizen. Or he is having Indian blood. That means his mother, mother's mother, and if honest, grandparents, parents, grandparents, great-grandparents are Indians, either mother's side or father's side. That means he is having Indian lineage. He is also called PIO. Then spouse quota. There are three types. Na? One is passport quota, then lineage or blood, the spouse. These three are called PIOs. If the fellow is having Indian passport, he is called PIO one type, first type one. That means he was an Indian citizen born, but he went abroad, he got the. He never held Indian passport. He is not born in India also. He was not, because he got abroad only. But his parents, grandparents, great grandparents are Indians. He can be called as PIO 2. Third one, any spouse of NRI or PIO, also PIOs only. Third category, spouse quota. Example, Sania Mirza husband, Priyanka Chopra husband. They are PIO 3s. Their spouses are Indians. Sohaib Malik, Nick Jonas, all these things. These are three types of PIOs. So, for these NRIs and PIOs only, you can open NRI deposits. That's all. NRO account. For foreign nationals, you can open NRO account only, not NRI account. Like the NRI account, there are six accounts are there. NRE, NRO, then FCNR, RFC, RFCD, EFC account. Out of it, foreign currency accounts are FCNR, EFC, RFC, and RFCD are foreign currency accounts. NRE, NRO are domestic accounts. Very important, no? Foreign currency. So this you simply just go to the table. Who can open NRE account? NRE, FCNR, only NRIs and PIOs can open. There are three types of customers. No? One is resident Indian, non-resident Indian, returning NRI. He was NRI, came back. No? So NRIs can open NRE, NRO, FCNR, RFC. Four accounts they can open. Foreign nationals can open NRO account only. Returning NRIs can open RFC account. RFC account can be opened by returning NRIs only. They can hold the amount for 3 years in foreign currency account. RFCD can be opened by Indian citizens only, resident Indians only. Resident Indians or Indian residents. They can open an RFC account. EFC account can be opened by Indians only. The difference is, if I earn the exchange, I will keep an EFC account. If I got some amount as a gift or something, other sources, I will park in RFCD account. So RFCD and EFC accounts are short-term accounts or foreign currency accounts permitted to Indian residents. And you can park them only for 1 month ending. The whatever for next month ending, you have to convert them into Indian rupees. Very important question. RFCD and EFC account are to be converted into Indian rupees by the end of next month. Very important. These two are the windows. Foreign currency account. Residents can open foreign currency accounts in two ways. Diamond dollar account is different. There are three ways. But two ways are popular. RFCD account and EFC account are the two foreign currency accounts for resident Indians. So Indian residents, not Indian residents. So they are short-term windows. They can open for only, they can park the funds only. They can open the account, but funds can be parked only for 1 month. Next month ending, they have to convert. Calendar month, na? Any funds came in Jan, Feb, they have to convert to Indian rupees. Definite question. In the month of February, they got some money. They have to convert in the month of March. Either they can use or convert. What is different between EFC and RFCD account? Suppose I went to some Singapore and gave a lecture, I got some money. I can keep in my EFC account. My brother sent me some $100 gift. I can park in RFCD account. The difference is, if you earn the foreign exchange, keep in EFC account. If you got the amount by way of gift, keep in RFCD account. RFC account is for returning NRIs. Those who are coming back, they can keep for 3 years. Definite question. There must be NRI for at least 1 year. Any NRI who is having NRI status for at least 1 year, they can open RFC account. That's all. Then NRE, NRO, FCNR are covered. NRE, foreign FCNR account also, in foreign currency account, no conversion required. These are for accounts where and foreign exchange, under foreign exchange. So very foreign nationals, you can open only NRO accounts. Clear? Then how much you can remit from? Remit abroad from these accounts. NRE account unlimited. Whatever comes in, you can go out. NRO account, foreign nationals, whatever they brought, they can take it without any restriction. But sir, hello. Because AI, yes, sir. Because he has what is he is already has to be retail, sir. He want to take retail, so may go a little bit slow, slide. I will say, slide already changed, sir. So I think this kind of stop. I think the video streaming. I will change, sir. Okay, sir. Okay. I will reload. I think once again. Okay, I will just continue, sir. Just reload and continue. After what time date, sir? No, already this is 10 seconds past, sir. Gone, sir. It is okay. I think stopped. I think the screen here. I will just come back once again, sir. Okay. Sir, up to what time I have to continue, sir? Because he has taken 1 hour, na? Up to 5:30 I will continue, sir. Okay. Then I will start on the okay. Sorry, friends. I think the screen has some stopped sharing, moving. Now I update, refresh my screen. Go a little bit slow. As I told you, because forex may get 20. Let's repeat some points once again. As I told you, forex could be getting around 100 marks paper. Around 10 questions will come. 10 to 15 questions will come. Basic questions will be there. So we will be covering from exam point of view. Not all we can cover. So what are the basic aspects we are covering? We are having NRE deposits, na? When RBI is the authority for foreign exchange. RBI has given powers to some dealers to deal in foreign exchange. They are called authorized dealers or persons. Very important. Authorized dealer one means our bank is AD1. Common, they are asking the question. There are three types of dealers in foreign exchange. AD1 means a person who can do all types of transactions. Just the example, you remember the exercise only. Canara Bank, all banks are AD1 dealers. That means you can do all types of transactions. AD2 means they can do only some transactions. It's theory question only, like NABARD, all these things. AD3, they are definite question they are asking. What is meant by AD3 means money changers. Common question in all levels. Full-fledged money changers and restricted money changers are AD3. We are AD1. So, question is AD1 means we are authorized dealer 1. We can do all transactions. AD2, very few common, Exim Bank, NABARD, all these things. They can do all transactions for themselves, not for customers. AD3 means full-fledged money changers. That means definite question. In airports, you'll be seeing full-fledged means they can both buy and sell. RMC means they can only buy. Any airport foreign national comes, they will buy foreign currency and give Indian rupees. So there are three types of dealers. One question will come. Dealer types. Next, there are four types of branches. In AD1, also in Canara Bank also, there are three types of branches. Very important question. A branch, B branch, C branch. Common, last time also we got this question. C branch means, don't get confused, all branches are C branches only. B branch means some branches, like your overseas branches, ITKA branches, all these branches. Without question, they are dealing, they are empowered to deal with all types of transactions, but they don't have independent Nostro Ostro account. Very important. We are having a lot of B branches in Canara Bank also. Examples are MCB, PCB, overseas branch, ITKA branch. This definite question you remember, please, because very important. There are three types of dealers. 1, 2, 3. We are one dealer. Two dealer is theory, no one will ask. Three means who are money changers, FFMC and RMC. Three types of branches are there. A, B, C. A means FDID. They are having position means they will be having a foreign exchange account with them. Either Nostro or Loro with them, Ostro with them. B means they are doing all transactions in foreign exchange, but they don't have any own account without position. C branches means all other branches. But Canara Bank, all branches can do all transactions. But only thing is C branch can have to do with the help of B or A. They can't keep the documents. So exam point of view, B means any bank which is empowered, they can do all transactions. A means they can do any transaction with position. C means all other branches. Clear? Then, because how basic questions, there are five broad types of foreign exchange transactions. All remittances, very important. Remittances are inward and outward remittances. Normally, our NRI customers are the source of remittances. Who is called NRI? Very, very important. Non-resident Indian, I told you. As per Section B1 of PEMA Act, a person who is staying abroad 183 days, he is called non-resident Indian. Very important. Any person who is staying abroad for 183 days, he is called non-resident. This is very important aspect. So, 183 plus non-resident, others are called residents. So, remittances, NRIs are the main sources of remittances in India because they are sending a lot of amount. So, remittances are governed by FEMA Act. So, NRI deposits, how many deposits I covered in the other slide? There are five types of NRI. There are total six deposits. NRI, in NRI, there are total six deposits. One is NRI account. Second is NRO account. Third is FCNR. Fourth is RFCD, RFC, and EFC. There are total six accounts. SNR account, not three now, because you can ignore. Because exam point of view, these six accounts you by heart. NRE, NRO, FCNR, RFC, RFCD, and EFC. Out of these six accounts, four are foreign currency accounts. What are the four foreign currency accounts? FCNR, RFC, RFCD and EFC. FCNR means foreign currency non-resident account. RFC means resident foreign currency account. Resident foreign currency domestic. EFC. These four accounts are foreign currency accounts. Remaining two, NRE, NRO are Indian rupee accounts. non-resident Indians and PIOs can open NRE, FCNR, NRO accounts. Very important. Who can open which account means non-resident Indians can open. NRIs can open. You write down three accounts. Na? NRIs and PIOs, I told you, there are three types of PIOs. One is person having Indian passport at some time. Those who is having any passport with him, he was there. Now, suppose I went abroad, I took that citizenship. I will be called as PIO because I was born in India and I have an Indian passport sometime. Those who are not having Indian passport, but they have Indian blood with them because they are born to their lineage is Indian. Their grandparents, great-grandparents or parents are Indians means they are called PIO 2, type 2. Those who are married to Indian NRI or PIOs are called PIO 3s. So, NRI account can be opened by any of these three customers, either NRIs, PIOs or PIO, no, PIO spouses. You can open them NRE, NRO, FCNR. Who can open RFC account? Returning NRI. Those who was in NRI for 1 year, when he is coming back to India, he can open RFC account and he can keep the foreign currency deposit for 1 or 3 years there. For resident Indians, what are the forex facilities? I can keep my forex in RFC D account or EFC account. What is RFC D account? For RFC D, any gifts, because if I got some $1,000 from my brother, I can park in a RFC D account to book a ticket. If I got some 100 rupees, $100 honorarium for any lecture, I can park it EFC account. The difference between RFC D and EFC is the nature of the source of the money. If the source is gift, you have to keep in RFC D. If the source is income, earning, you can keep in EFC account. So these six accounts, by exam point of view, go through. EFC and RFC accounts time frame, very important. You can't keep the foreign currency permanently. Whatever credit amount this credit is this month, that amount should convert into Indian rupees by the end of next month. Suppose I got $1,000 to buy a flight ticket from my brother. I should use this amount before January 31st. Or before February 28th, maximum I have to use. If I am not choosing, it will go, we have to convert into Indian rupees. So these are the, then trade is governed by FEMA and DGFT. Capital flows are governed by RBI and FIPB. These are the broad transactions in foreign currency. So FCRM is very important, Foreign Currency Regulation Act. So all remittance transactions are governed by, and now definite question, all FCRA, how to be routed through only State Bank of India, main branch in New Delhi. Very important. Government has banned to ensure control. All foreign currency, all foreign contributions, they are regulated now. Whoever getting foreign money, NGOs, all these things, they have to send that money through State Bank of India, main branch in New Delhi. Through them only, they have to get all donations. Coming to trade, so now other important transactions is, what is a capital account transaction? Current in foreign exchange, the next important after rate, all these things is current account, capital account transactions. Any capital account transaction means it alters current account transaction, sir. Any transaction which will affect the position of asset and liabilities of a resident is known as capital account transaction. Because na, if any transaction, if a resident Indian's abroad liability asset are changes, it is called capital account transaction. If a non-resident Indian's Indian liability or asset changes, it is called a capital account transaction. Simple exam point of view. I am buying a flat in Singapore. My asset abroad is changing. It's a capital account transaction. My brother is buying flat in Chennai. He's an NRA. He is a non-resident Indian. Indian asset is changing. it's a capital account transaction. NRE deposit opening. Non-residents deposit is an asset. Indian asset is growing. So NRE deposits are capital account transactions. Common question. Whether opening NRE deposit, current account or capital account transaction, it is a capital account transaction. Simple logic. Under foreign exchange transactions, all transactions are classified as capital or current account transactions. What is meant by capital account transaction? There are two types of customers, resident, non-resident. If any resident's asset or liability changes abroad, that means I am buying an asset, buying a share, or taking a loan from abroad, it is a capital account transaction. Suppose non-resident, he is buying some property in India, he is depositing some amount in India, he is buying some shares in India, that is called a capital account transaction. Current account means other transactions. From exam point of view, current account transactions, all are permitted, only three are prohibited. Capital account transactions, all are prohibited, only some are permitted. That's all. Exam point of view, current account transactions, all are permitted. Only three are prohibited. Capital account transactions, all are prohibited, only few are permitted. What are the prohibited and current account? Definite question. In Schedule 1, for current,
Satish sir, you have
for current account transactions, fully banned.
Sir, Satish sir.
Yes, sir.
You have to change the slide, sir. It is what you are explaining is in third slide, I believe.
Change the slide only, sir.
No, it is showing second. Quick recap.
Yes, sir.
You are talking about current account and capital account, but it is showing quick recap.
It is showing current account convertible only. I am showing, sir. Fully banned, government has permitted. Same slide is coming, sir.
No, it is showing, for us, it is showing second slide. I think you are dealing third slide.
Okay, I'll change it now, sir. Current account transactions, it is fully convertible and
slide
very important. Changed. There are three schedules given. There are three schedules are coming for you, sir. No. Fully banned, government of India has to permit, RBI has to permit.
No, that slide is not coming. Quick recap, second slide in your PowerPoint. That is only you are displaying.
There's some problem with it, I think. May come out and come in otherwise once again, sir.
PowerPoint, you exit and come again. You close your PowerPoint, come again.
Okay, sir.
Now only it is showing that
it's coming, sir. Now only I gave you 20 second slide, sir.
Yeah, 20 second slide it is showing now.
So friends, there is some problem in this one. There are two types of transaction. I told you, just quickly repeat. The current account, capital account.
No, you already explained, just to show the slide.
Okay, sir. Okay. Because only 1 to 3 enough, sir, because when you basically they're asking.
Correct.
1 to 12, they asked only which is banned.
What is difference between current account and capital account? No, that slide you show. Definition. The definition you put, no?
Simple. Any transaction which will affect the position of assets and liabilities of a resident in India are called capital. No? Resident abroad or non-resident in India are called capital account. Simple logic. They have to change the liability or asset. Indian abroad, non-resident in India. That's all. Simple. So, example is NRA deposit. Foreigners, NRA is staying abroad. His Indian asset is going up like that. He is buying a flat in Chennai. Going up. So, they are called capital account transactions. Current account transaction means no change in asset and liability. My brother is giving a gift to me. There is no change in asset and liability. That is called current account transaction. From exam point of view, very important. All current account transactions are permitted. Only three are banned. One is Nepal, Bhutan, fully banned. And some Schedule 1 items fully banned. Like gambling, lotteries, all these things. Did you remember? Current account, all are permitted except three schedules. The exam point of first schedule one fully banned Nepal, Bhutan, and other transitions. Schedule two, government has to permit. Example is sports and any sports groups, all these things. Ministry of any dance troop, musical parties. Ministry of Home has to permit. Department of Culture, like that. Schedule two transaction, government has to permit. Schedule three transactions, RBI has to permit. That's exam point. You remember like that. In current account transaction, there are three schedules. All are permitted, but prohibited. They are given three schedules. That three schedules are not fully prohibited. Only one is fully banned. Example, Nepal, Bhutan transactions and some eight transactions like gambling, etc. Schedule two is government can permit. If you want to send amount for overseas advertising, transponder lease, shipping overseas, any dance party. A simple example is any cultural troops, even though they are asking $1,000, they can't take it on their own. Iravaja musical party, all these things. Ministry of Home has to permit. Any sports, Ministry of Home, like that. All these schedule two transactions, government has to permit. Schedule three transactions, who has to permit? RBI. What are the transactions? Any person can take 2.5 lakhs abroad under LRS. Indian citizens are empowered to take any transaction, either current or capital account transaction, up to 2.5 lakhs under LRS. All permitted transactions. If the party wants more, suppose a medical medical amount, I can 2.5 lakhs I can take. If I want to exceed the ceiling, it is Schedule 3. RBI can permit. So these three exam points, you remember, that's all. Nothing is there.
Sir, LRS means one person is asking.
Yes, sir.
LRS expansion, you tell them.
I just give the example.
No, you don't.
Because that is very important. Last time the questions came from it, sir. LRS.
Yeah. Don't worry, boss. We will share the PPT. Many people are asking PPT. We will share it.
I will share it, sir.
Presently, you will try to listen the class. You forget about PPT. What you are searching, sir?
We'll share the PPT, sir. No problem, sir.
I think you are covered fully.
So capital I have covered. Sir, LRS they want, I will share the PPT to them, sir, because a lot of time under LRS scheme, liberalized remittance scheme, because very important.
No, just expansion. I don't think it will, questions will be in detail so much for clerical.
Only because, friends, simple logic, in how much I can take abroad from my SB account. Logic is liberalized remittance scheme means earlier we were very tight, $5,000, $10,000, like that. Now it came to 2.5 lakhs per annum, 2.5 lakh dollars, 2.5 in million means 0.25 million or 2,50,000 dollars without any concurrence. Simply, I can take abroad for any approved purposes. If I am overstating, suppose medical treatment, investment, gift, whatever purpose you want, all transactions you can take abroad, this 2.5 lakhs. Any SB account customer, if you're exceeding that amount, it becomes Schedule 3, RBI will give permission. Similarly, from NRE account, how much you can take? Because very important question. One question will come from this angle. SB account, 2.5 lakhs I can take out. NRE account, unlimited. whatever comes in, I can take it out. NRO account, how much I can take? 1 million, definite question. $1 million means 10 lakhs USD, I can take out. This is for NRIs. Otherwise, foreign nationals, they can take out whatever in their NRO account balance. These three, you remember. SB account, outward remittance, LRS, 2.5 lakhs per year, no restriction. NRE accounts, unlimited. NRO accounts, non-resident ordinary accounts, $10 lakh. That means $1 million per annum. If it is NRO account in the name of foreign national, they have this 1 million is not applicable for them. They can take out their amount while closing the account. Very important guidelines. And same way, how much currency I can bring inside? Definite question. Last time also all levels it came. You can bring a total any amount of banking currency you can bring through banking channels. Anyone through normal banking channels, there is no restriction. But if you are bringing currency in the form of traveler's check or cash, 10,000 is the ceiling. Beyond that, you have to obtain CD. You have to submit CDF, currency declaration form. What is the 10,000? Out of 10,000 also, in hard cash format, you can bring only $5,000 equivalent. So very important question, when I am bringing foreign currency inside, in cash format, how much I can bring? Normal banking channels, you can bring any amount. Cash format, you can bring only $5,000 equivalent. Including cash and traveler's checks, you can bring up to $10,000. Beyond that, you have to submit a currency declaration form. You can bring, but you have to carry that form wherever you go. Same way, very important question, how much money I can send abroad in cash, take in cash format? Banking channels, you can send up to 2.5 lakhs from SB account or RBI permission required. In cash format, in a hard currency format, how much you can take abroad? They are very clear. All countries, you can take only $3,000 or equivalent. 3, 5, unlimited. You remember the 3, 5, 2.5 lakhs. All currencies, all countries, Europe, all these countries, you can take only $3,000 with you while going abroad. Only Iraq and Libya, you can take $5,000. 5. Iran, Russian CIC states, you can take entire $2.5 lakh in cash. Any citizen can remit $2.5 lakh abroad through banking channels. No problem. In currency format, how much you can take? Currency, there are three variants. One question definite. Iraq and Libya, 3,000. All countries, 3,000. Iraq and Libya, 5,000. Russia and CIS states, Azerbaijan, all these states, and Iran, you can take 2,50,000 in cash. Very, very important. In case of Hajj pilgrimage, you can take 2.5 or as per Hajj Club recommendation. Now it is 1 lakh. So these are the four exceptions, four layers. One question guarantee. How much currency you can take abroad? $3,000 all countries. 5,000 Iraq and Libya. Russian CIS states and Iran, 2.5 lakhs. Saudi Arabia has 1 lakh. Same way, how much Indian rupees you can take abroad? Indian currency now, revised guidelines, 25,000 rupees only you can take abroad and word. From Nepal, Bhutan, any amount you can bring, definite question, but you can't bring in any other currency except 150s. Up to 100 only you can use. 500, 2000 banned. Nepal and Bhutan, you can bring any amount, but the currency should be in the form of 100 rupees and less than denomination. This is about remittances. Very important. No? Remittances under LRS, 2.5 lakhs. And NRE account unlimited, NRO account 1 million. Currency format 3,000, 5,000, 2.5 lakhs. Inward $5,000 and 10,000 including TC. Beyond that, CDF is required. Indian rupees, both out and in, 25,000 rupees only you can export or import. Only from Nepal, Bhutan, you can bring any amount subject to currency is only 100 rupees or 50 rupees notes. This is about denomination. Now we'll go to quickly about trade aspect of foreign exchange. Now only exam point I will cover. Foreign trade policy is up to 31st March it is there. Very important. 5 years policy. Then DGFT is Director General of Foreign Trade. they will be implementing the foreign trade policy. Very important. They will issue IE code. IE code, common question, this level. IE code means in importer exporter code. This is given to, because three codes in export import, there are three codes. Foreign exchange, one is remittances I have covered. Now export import trade related experts, very important. Definitely five questions will come. Common question is IE code. What is meant by IE code? IE code means importer exporter code to the customers. It is now they are giving only PAN number as IE code. So alphanumeric 10 digit. Then for all merchandise, DGFT will give one code. That is called ITC HSN code. Definite question. HSN codes are being used in our GSTN package also. That is called Indian Trade Classification Organized System Nomenclature. This is for merchandise. And so these are the, when you are exporting importer, the customer should need IE code mandatory. Then he should ensure that the ITC code is there for the merchandise. Very important question. ITC merchandise is classified into four types. One is free. That means no license required. Restricted means export import license required. Definite question. Canalized means state trading enterprise. Only government agencies can deal with them. Fee means prohibited. So when you are entering any export import transaction, first you must check IE code. Then you go for the commodity code. ITC HSN code you have to go. ITC HSN definite code. It is how many digits? IE code is alphanumeric PAN only. ITC HSN code, it is 8-digit code, number code only, very important. First digits from global code, it matches with global sequence. Last two Indian code. Exam point of view, remember, IE code, PAN number only. ITC code, how many digits? 8 digits, number only. Then how much classification code? Free means no license required. Restricted license required. Canalized means only government can deal. P prohibited. This you by heart, one question guarantee. Classification code for merchandise, HSN codes are classified into four types. Indian merchandise, four type classification. Only free items you can export or import. Restricted, license is required. Without export import license, you can't do it. This list is dynamic, okay? Exam point, remember, FRCP. Then, very important, customs also, the customs duties will be there, anti-dumping, controlling duties, customs will levy. There are four packages, ICE gate customs are very Indian customs e-gateway. These four definitions, one definitely will come. Please by heart these four definitions. Example, ICE gate means Indian customs EDI gateway or electronic gateway. By heart this definition, Indian customs electronic data interface gateway or EDI gateway they call, but they are simply calling it as e-gateway. Then EDPMS, Export Data Processing and Monitoring System. Very important question. IDPMS, Import Data and Processing and Monitoring System. FETRS, what is FETRS? Foreign Exchange Transactions E-Reporting System. These four, one will come definitely because India is totally online. Very important. This exam point of view, four you by heart. In Export Data, EDPMS, then one more exam. Exam point of view, when you are exporting something, customs will give you shipping bill or ZR, proof of export, shipping bill. Just by heart this exam point of view. When you are exporting something, customs will give you shipping bill. In what? Not in physical form, now electronic form. In EDPMS form, EDPMS package, customs will upload your shipping bill when you are exporting something. When you are importing something, customs will give you bill of entry in IDPMS package. Where these two you by heart. Proof of export, shipping bill. Proof of import, bill of entry. Given by whom? Customs. How they will load? They will give physical copy also. Immediately they will send the data to our RBI portal and banks also will get it. Through which package? ICEGATE EDPMS, ICEGATE IDPMS. This is very important. Just remember example. Shipping bill, bill of entry. If you are not familiar with foreign exchange, just by heart, new terms. Export proof means when I'm exporting something, customs will give me one shipping bill number. It contains so-and-so pence has exported with so-and-so value like that. Proof of import will be bill of entry. That this many goods were imported with this much value like that, they will give you a bill of entry. So logic is for all GRs, they must be inward remittance. Very important. when you export something, money will come to you. Exporters will get inward remittance. Bill of entry, importers will send outward remittance. That's all. You remember like that, na? All export bills, you get inward remittance. All import bills, you have to send outward remittance. So I'll quickly cover LC terms. No? What is it? In all export import transactions, there is a concept called bill of exchange. Very important. No? In simple terms, NI Act, you forget. Bill is reverse of check. Check always flows from debtor to seller, buyer to seller. If I buy something, no? Bill is reverse of it. Bill is drawn. I sold some goods to you. I draw a bill on you. Simple logic. Check always flows from buyer to seller. Bill is reverse of check. Always in trade transactions, bill forms the base. Very important. Exam point of view, think that bill is nothing but a base of the trade transaction. Global everything, forex everything, bill is the fundamental aspect. Bill is drawn by whom? Very important. Common question, bill is always drawn by the exporter and importer. Just remember, bill is nothing but reverse of check. It is drawn by the exporter on the importer. So that is called bill of exchange, yes, na? So what is meant by LC? Always buyer wants goods first, seller wants money first. They don't trust each other. So banks step in and resolve the conflict. Now what bank says? Bank will issue LC. What is meant by LC? It is letter of credit. What is the advantage of LC means? Bank always issue LC on behalf of the buyer in favor of seller. What LC says? We ask the buyer to ship the merchandise and send the documents to us, to me. I will pay you money without recourse to the buyer. This is the role of LC. Very important. Na? LC means LC. One question will definitely come. LC is always issued by whom? Importer's bank. Always na, on the buyer, behalf of buyer. Buyer is importer. In forex, seller is exporter. You remember like that. Always buyers are importers. Sellers are exporters. LC is issued by whom? LC is issued by buyer's bank, importing bank to exporter. LC always say, you do the shipment, you don't worry. You send the goods to the fellow, I will pay you money. You send me the documents. The proof of the shipment is done. I will pay you money without touching him. Even if you don't pay also, I will pay you. So this is the most, LC is facilitating world trade. Exam point of view, remember that LC is issued by importer's bank. So what... So there are four types of LC issue. Na? LC issuing. Na? Always LC, a bank always issue LC means. Now, so that's why, na, if now a buyer's bank is LVB and seller's bank is PNB. Seller don't want the LC issued by LVB. Say class, na, always buyer's bank will issue LVB. Na. Buyer's bank is LVB means seller don't want the LC issued by LVB. So he don't trust because he is not trusting the party, not trusting the bank also. Then what we can do at Canara Bank, we will add our confirmation to that LC and we will become the confirming bank. Na. Here, this is called confirmation of LC because here the risk is involved is if LVB does not pay, we have to pay. So LC issue, there are four types. Issuance of LC is there. Confirmation of LC is there. Then third one is advising LC. Advising LC means, now suppose the Citibank New York and Sellers Bank is LVB Chennai. They don't have Swift message. Now world messaging flows to Swift only. If they don't have Swift, Canara Bank will download the message, will do postman job. Are this LC came to you, just do it. So there are three aspects in LC. LC opening, confirmation, advising. LC opening, we are taking the risk of the borrower. If buyer is not paying, we have to pay. LC advising, we don't have any risk. We are doing just postman job. LC confirmation, we are taking the risk of other bank. If that bank is not paying, we have to pay. So these are the base. There are three aspects of LC: issuance, advising, confirmation, and reimburse. Four aspects. These you buy here. Just issuance means we are issuing LC on our on behalf party. Confirming means some other bank we are confirming. We are giving our name to the other bank. Some risk is there. Advising, no risk. Reimbursing, no risk. There are four transactions. You just example you buy heart. LC is always issued by importer's bank to exporter. That's all. Then Swift is very important. What is meant by Swift? All global foreign exchange transaction messaging will happen through Swift only. Swift means Society for Worldwide Interbank Financial Telecommunication. This you buy heart. Swift messages. There are several types of messages, all call MT103, like the MT followed by number, MT103, MT201, like that. Common message is MT103 message. It is mail transfer 103. It is called funds transfer. Swift, just buy out this. MT103 is funds transfer. All foreign exchange funds, that means you are issuing a check, just like issuing a check. Or it's an electronic check. So that bank, Swift message, MT103 is issuance of check. MT202 is bank-to-bank transactions, RDS transactions. Other transaction is MT700 LC, 707 LC amendment, 760 bank guarantee, 767 amendment. There are four transactions you buy heart. Swift is the just like our domestic SFMS. It is a messaging system. There are four methods in Swift. Swift message. MT103 is a popular mode customer transfer. It is bank-to-bank instructions. Now, where you are issuing MT103 means customer funds transfer just by heart. If you got MT103 means you got funds. If you are issuing MT103 means you are sent abroad. Same way, 202 is bank-to-bank transfer. Just you by heart from exam point of view. MT103 inward message. 103 outward means you are sending money. Okay. 202 is inward means inward message. Outward means you are sending money. Same way, MT700 is LC opening, 700, 760 important messages. LC opening is 700. LC bank guarantee opening is 760. LC confirmation is 707. BZ confirmation is 760. Amendment is 767. These six messages you buy heart. MT103, 202, 700, 760, 707, 767. These four you write. I will share the PPT to you. These are very important. Common. Then there are incoterms. From exam point of view, covered in the books also. These seven incoterms you buy. There are 11 incoterms. UCP 600 is the guidelines for LC issuance worldwide. Just to remember the number, UCP 600 means UCPD 600, Uniform Customs and Practices for Documentary Rates. These six documents, these six documents govern the world trade. Incoterms means international commercial terms. There are 11 terms which define the nature of the trade. UCP 600 means Uniform Customs and Practices Documentary Credits. This is a document for LCs. It is, just remember, it is governing issued by the UCP 600 is the latest document. URR is a collection rules. Uniform Rules for Reimbursement 725 is the latest document. Remember the number. ISBP 745 means International Standard Banking Practices 745. URDG means Uniform Rules for Demand Guarantee 758. These six you buy heart, one question issued. There are 11 incoterms and UCP 600, URR 725, ISBP 745, URDG 758, Doc Desk Rules 872. These six rules are governing world trade now. They are issued by International Chamber of Commerce. Exam point of view, these numbers you buy heart. It is UCP 600, 725, 745, 758, 872. This you remember. URDG means demand guarantees, bank, international bank guarantees rules. ISBP means it's a brochure. Just like now, it explains the details. Seven international standard banking practices. Doc Desk rules means what are the documents you have to submit for export import, 872. UCP 600 means It's a LC guidelines. UR 725 means guidelines for remitting for collection items. So this is a lot of time to be covered now, because exam point of view are condensed the content. And INCO terms, 11 terms are there. We are given the book. They will define the nature of the trade. This also you buy at 11 terms, you buy at FOB, FOS, all these things are there. CIF, CF, CFR. Time limits will cover next week, because these six you buy heart. That 11 terms, these four numbers you remember. Then very important, there are three stages of export finance. Against export order documents, customer has to write the avail to packing credit. There are three stages of packing credit. One is customer getting order, then he is generating, he is manufacturing the goods, then he is doing shipment, then getting funds. In any export transaction, there are four transactions. First, getting an order. Second, manufacturing for the order. Third, completing the shipment. Fourth, getting funds. When there is no order, there is no right for the customer to avail PC. But once the party is having export order, he has any export customer having export order has the right to avail PC. Very important. Export credit, you can't reject on your own. The MDCO of the institution has to concur with the rejection. Very important question. In any export proposal is rejected, it has to be placed before MDCO of the firm also, come bank. He has to concur. So, once the order is there, we will extend him packing credit. That is called packing credit. PC means export finance. Where the PC goes, it goes to CASA. Always PC goes to current account. Then you will buy. So, after PC, when the shipment, this is called pre-shipment credit, because shipment not happened. We have financed for the shipment of the packing of the goods. This is called packing credit. Then when the shipment happens, he has packed everything. Then he will submit the bill. I told you bill means bill of exchange, some set of documents. We will cover it later. This bill means export bill. When the bill once again, what we will do, this bill amount will convert into Indian rupees and credit the amount to PC. What happens then? Once the bill has reached the overseas country, the overseas bank pays us the amount through MT103 or 202 to our account. That amount will convert into Indian rupees, we adjust the bill. So these are the three steps in export finance. First is PC to CASA, then bill to PC, then inward remittance to bill. So once the inward remittance is not coming, means party has to claim his own funds. We have to charge more. So this is called pre-shipment credit. Second one is called post-shipment credit. These two are very important. Just before shipment, it is called packing credit. Amount goes to CASA. Here, if conversion is not happening, only Indian rupees will give. Then once the bill is submitted, we'll buy the bill at bill buying rate. Some bill will buy the bill and convert them in Indian rupees and close the PC account. When inward remittance comes from abroad, with that same amount, we'll adjust the bill. If party has not could not get the money, he has sent the goods, the overseas buyer is not paying the goods. After the due date of bill, after 15 days, we'll close the bill, we'll crystallize the bill. So that is called, we'll sell them and close the bill. We'll recover the money from the party only. So these are the three steps. First PC to CASA, then bill to PC, then inward remittance IBA to bill. These three steps are there in any export credit.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi, sir.
Sir,
yeah, we finished, sir. Hello. Hello. Sir, Satish, sir.
Ah, sir. Hello.
Yeah, tell me, sir.
Sir, may I continue for some time, eh?
You have some more points to add,
I can cover this risk weight and this one,
Whether it's, that much will come, sir, for them.
I will just call you mobile 7 minutes, sir. Sir, actually retail also he has prepared, sir. Recovery Jagannath sir want to take, so if any other topic may cover, because overlapping, it's not overlapping. Leave it now, because actually Mr. Raikumar morning spoke to me, sir. He actually is free and he has covered detail also, he has prepared everything he told. Yes, sir, because that's why it took you now 1 hour he has covered, that's why it should not overlap this topic also. If you want, I will cover risk capital master, I can cover if you want, otherwise I will leave it. For them, because very tough, the non-discipline required, sir, that's the problem. Because they will get confused, that's why, sir. I will just send goodbye and share the PPT to them, sir. Okay. Tomorrow you can load it. Because honestly, you get confused, sir, because bill will be good. Any of them are prepared, okay, sir. I'll just say goodbye, sir. Okay.
Yes, sir. So, go over now, sir. Right, Kumar, sir?
1 second, sir.
Yeah. Sir, you are searching for any files, sir? Sir, Satish, sir.
Yes, sir.
Go ahead, sir. No, we can wind up, sir. No problem.
Other time, just winding up, sir. Something, anything coming to screen, sir?
Yeah, yeah, coming. So, yeah. Shall I tell?
You can tell, sir. I'll close it, sir. Okay.
Yeah, yeah, close it, sir. Sir, thank you, sir. Thank you, Mr. Siva Satish. Thanks to all the participants.
Thank you,
sir. Thanks to all the participants for having joined. For tomorrow's session, I will be sharing the link shortly in all the groups, WhatsApp group and Telegram group. So I have already posted the question paper, test paper 2 and PowerPoint to be handled tomorrow. Those test paper you can download and take a printout for tomorrow's class.
Sir, I will share Forex PPT by tomorrow, sir. I will, you can download them, sir.
Okay? No problem, no problem.
Okay, thank you, sir. Okay.
Whatever is materials are shared, it will be posted in the Google Drive.
Okay, sir, okay.
Video of morning session has been already posted in YouTube. Your participant can watch class on over YouTube also. This session also will be posted in YouTube. Tomorrow morning, Mr. Jagannathan sir will be taking class. As usual, he will be handling question paper. That question paper has been already put in our Google Drive. Afternoon, one Mr. DGM, Mr. Saukar sir will be handling the session. So be ready for the both the sessions. Tomorrow morning session, I will be sharing the link by evening today. For tomorrow afternoon session, I will share the Zoom link in the morning. Thank you. Good night to all of you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.